Senator Reagan, thank you very much for joining us this evening. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Well, what we're here to talk about is this bill that, in a very curious way, was yanked off the floor yesterday. And you weren't there. Who was that mysterious phone call from?
Well, I had some business to take care of, and I took care of the business. And when I got back, the vote was taken. And I understand the bill was pulled from the agenda. Vote was expunged. I've never seen that done before, to be honest with you.
Well, before we get to that, and it was very unusual, that was a very well-timed phone call, as it turns out.
Well, I don't think it's a phone call that had much to do with anything. I think had I been on the floor, I would have voted no.
You would have.
And so had I voted no, it still would not have been the ability to get the bill passed. So I don't think, I think it was still 30, or it would have been 31 no's, you know, versus, you know, 30 or 29 yeses. So I think the bill had didn't have the ability to get passed because of the three Democrats that voted against it, Sikorski, Valesky, and
Aubertine. What is wrong with the bill in your eyes?
I think that it's a little premature. They were supposed to start it in California. And if you understand the bill, the manufacturers have to put on a serial number in the gun on the firing pin that will hit the shell and will have a number on that shell. So by the time you create that first set of guns that are going to be sold here in the state of New York, or anybody that sells to the state of New York,
right,
would have to have that in place. So that in itself, by the time the technology really gets underway, you're talking several years down the road before it becomes a tool that the police departments can use. I believe we should give as many tools as we can to the police departments, but it has to be a proven tool that it does work. Now, the California has put it off, and they were supposed to implement it in January of 2010, and they haven't, gives us a little pause to rush into something.
Okay, so this bill, I mean, did you see, it's an issue that Mayor Bloomberg, who is very passionate about gun violence and illegal guns, he has a whole organization of mayors against illegal guns that he funds. He was in Albany making not so frequent appearances. He makes not a lot of personal appearances lobbying for this bill, met behind closed doors with your conference, put out a statement after this bill was yanked from the floor that was very harshly worded. Did you see it?
I've seen parts of it, I think, on different blogs, yes.
Haven't
seen the letter itself.
He accused people who had voted no of siding with the special interests against law enforcement and mayors and other and district attorneys who want to help protect innocent victims who are killed. That's a very strongly worded statement. Do you see yourself as on the side of people who would prefer to see people killed?
I'm a former New York City police officer.
I'm aware.
And I'm the guy that put the legislation that's out there today that if you get caught with an illegal handgun, you get 3 years in jail. That's my legislation here in the state of New York. Plastico from the Giants went to jail for 2.5 years because of my legislation.
Has he called you about that?
No, he hasn't. But I will tell you, anybody that has an illegal gun should go to jail. But we do sell 30,000 legal guns here in the state of New York every year. So you want to make sure that the people that sell these guns, whether it be Remington or whoever, that they have the ability to sell their product in this state and make a profit. So you don't want to hurt any one industry. So what we're only thing we're asking is that if the technology works, then we don't have a problem with it. So what we're asking, put a date out, put it into 2013, let the technology catch up, and the technology catch up with the year, and then we'll be ready. We'll pass that bill, I think, tomorrow morning.
So it wasn't about the gun lobby. It wasn't about,
no.
I mean, there was an enormous amount of lobbying that went on by a very well-funded bunch of people who are, I don't want to say pro-gun, but who are on the other side of this argument.
Correct. This is not, there are a number of people that believe that it's going to increase the cost of guns. So there's an argument there for that. There is a piece in the legislation that says it will cost no more than $12. So they've already tried to, figure out some cost to this firing pin and what it would cost. But you got to remember, that's just to the firing pin. Now you got to create the technology that's got to be able to view the shell, get the number down correctly, make sure there's a registration at a shell. So there is quite a bit of cost to this at the end of the day. you know, we have something here that Governor Pataki created back 7 or 8 years ago, and I believe it's cost us like $34 million, and it's been a complete failure. So we don't want to do things that are not going to work here in the state of New York. We just want something that works.
Okay. There's also a political aspect to this. Mayor Bloomberg, who has given more than $1 million to the Senate Republicans since 2003, most of it in since 2008, actually $500,000 right before this major fight between the Democrats and the Republicans, which the Republicans lost for control of the chamber in the last election cycle. He had a closed-door meeting with you guys, and one, a colleague of yours, Senator Libous from Binghamton, had some heated words with the mayor, according to sources of mine. Are you concerned that the mayor might no longer continue to support the Senate Republicans because of this bill?
No. I think Senator Libous and his ability to, and his passionate description of why crime has gone up here in the city and state of New York, it's because of all of the get-out-of-jail cards that the Democrats have passed, paroling all these individuals, paroling these cop killers. There's a whole host of legislation, the Rockefeller drug laws.
But what does that these have to do with microstamping, though?
Well, these are the laws that we should have been stopping all along, and that would probably prevent some of the crimes that we see being committed and some of the murders we see being committed. So it's no reason to stop microstamping, but it was a reason for I believe Senator Libous to explain himself in a way that said, listen, there's a whole host of things that have gone on in the state that have contributed to the rise in crime. And I think that's what give and take between the mayor and Tom was about.
It wasn't about a concern on the part of Mr. Libous, who of course heads the Senate Republican Campaign Committee, that maybe Mayor Bloomberg won't be supporting the Republicans anymore and might support the Democrats, who are in the majority this year.
No, I think you're pointing to something like like quid pro quos or something like that. If you do this, we'll give you that. The mayor has always been supportive of us for years and will continue to be supportive.
Are you
the mayor
sure?
I am positive. The mayor and I are good friends. We have a situation here that did not go well, but I'm sure it's not the end of the session yet. They have to make some corrections to the bill. It may get passed this session. And this is not the only issue. We have education, right? We have a revenue bill that's about to kill the city of New York.
Well, we haven't seen it yet.
Okay, but,
yes.
But they're going to go after the aid to localities, right? They're going to go after the education piece, right? These are all going to hurt the city of New York. That's where we have to spend our energies, working together with the mayor to make sure the city of New York and the rest of the state get a balance, not a some part of the state getting hurt to take care of another part of the state. You need balance in the system.
Have you spoken to him?
I've spoken to his people. I haven't spoken to the mayor since yesterday.
But you believe that he actually will continue to support the Senate Republicans financially? He's their largest, he's your largest single individual donor.
Mayor Mike Bloom and I get along extremely well, and we will continue to get along extremely well in the future. We have a lot in common. We have a lot of issues that we're going to work together on in the future. This is just a bump in the road that happens. The mayor's a great guy, but, you know, there's some things that just don't happen. We lost congestion pricing. We shouldn't have lost congestion pricing. We had the Jet Stadium in Manhattan. He lost. So there were a couple of issues that the mayor has lost on. But overall, if you take a look at what the mayor's been able to do for not only just the city, but the revenues that he's generated that's helped the state and the federal government, is astronomical. He's a real well thought out businessman that knows how to manage a city, and he's been very effective.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Senator, for talking to us about this bill. Mari Golden, thanks for joining us tonight.
Thank you, Liz.